teacher by profession, but now into decorations, baking, and events management. Today we host Amon Bazira as he takes us through his story from where he started to where he is today. A very warm welcome and a good evening. Brenda Kembabazi is my name. A very warm welcome, Amon. How are you?
I'm doing good, thank you.
We're glad to have you on today's show, and we hope that you will maybe give an idea or two to the youth that are watching you today. So just for you to take us a little into your background, take us through how you went through school.
I'm Amon Bazira. I started from Tiana. That's where I did my primary level. Then I went to Louisville Secondary School. After that, I joined Macquarie University, where I did my degree in education. Yes.
So that's the point where I actually wanted to start from. You actually went to school for 3 years to study education.
Yes.
And you're now into decorating. Mm. But tell us, after you had finished your degree in education, how did you start off in work?
After I finished my degree in education, I applied for vacancy in a secondary school. Lucky enough, I was given a chance. Then I joined, I was teaching HSC, I was teaching religious studies, then plus history. I taught for one term and I felt like things weren't moving.
How bad was that school?
Things weren't moving the way I expected. Then I had to start on my dream.
Okay, so when things failed out in education, why did you think of decorations?
Before I started my own campaign, during my vacations in year 6, I used to open a church, decorating the church, and like opening, doing the flower arrangement, all that. Then, like when I joined campus, I also started to join people who are doing decoration. Then I revised myself, then I said, okay, I think I can join decoration because I have an idea. Remember I told you like I was doing it at church, and we used to do it every weekend because we used to have functions at church every weekend. And so it was easier for me to move from education into decoration.
But of course, you starting your own business meant you needed capital. Had you saved in the only one term you had taught in school, how did you get the money?
I never saved with any capital. Just started by telling my friends that I can do decoration, I can do cakes, like that, word of mouth. The money they brought in was my capital.
So that
you I would use it. Okay. Yeah.
So about the baking, did you also go into school to study?
Yeah, for the baking, I went to Nairobi. I did my bakery course, then I came back to Uganda.
Okay.
Yes.
So tell us, starting off as a decorator, I know decorations, especially such things, are quite expensive. Mm. Do you own all of them, or even up to this point you rent some of them out?
I do have all of them, but some I also hire them out. Okay. Yes.
So tell us about the decorating kind of industry. How does it actually go for someone to become a decorator today? What does it take?
Since I had an idea within me and a dream, I started like being next to the people who can help me, who are already in the industry. I never started like my own company there and then. I started working with people. Then after that, that's when I built my own companies.
So what did it take? Because I imagine, aside of the capital, because you said for whatever business they gave you, what they gave you is what you managed with. So when you started getting big events, how did you adjust?
I started saving, and then I went to China. I started going to China last year. That's why I buy my own things.
So does that mean that right now, if I needed a decoration or a decorating like service for any event, you'd cater for it fully?
Yes, I would, because I have whatever it takes.
So how have you managed to grow your business in the shortest time? Because you say you started going to China just last year, and you've been here for about 6 months. So how have you managed to actually grow this business?
First of all, I put God first in whatever I do. Always give my tithe.
Yeah, tithe never.
Yeah, I always give my tithe. Then always make sure that my customers, I satisfy them.
So how do you manage to promote your own business? How does someone get to know about A-Classic Decorations?
First of all, whatever function I do, I make sure that I do it with all my energy. And it brings more customers. People start looking for you at the wedding, then. Then after that, like, I also advertise on Facebook, in magazines, on TVs.
So for someone your age, someone would imagine, how has he done it and how is he doing it? Many a times it's a cliche that decorators are usually women. So how have you managed to make it in a so-called female field?
In that area, like it's not for only women, because also men can do it. That's why I joined it. The person who inspired him was a male person, was doing the decoration.
you growing your business, what kind of challenges did you see before you actually brought it to where it is today, what the rest of us see as a good business? Take us through the nitty-gritties of those difficulties you went through to raise this business.
The challenges, first of all, the challenges, for example, the weather. Sometimes the time we are going to decorate a wedding, an open wedding, the rain comes. Another thing, like sometimes the customer, they are not trustworthy. They don't pay you in time. Some will reach on their wedding day or their party day. They dodge you, wait, you have done your job.
So how do you manage to pull through even all those challenges, especially when it comes to customers that do not pay?
Customers, since like the business has grown, before the wedding or before any party, they have to pay 100%. I can't go to the venue when they haven't paid because of my previous experiences with their clients. Yes.
So tell us, what is Amon Bazira's day like? How does your day start and how do you end it?
My day starts at around 6. I wake up in the morning. I do my prayers for about 1 hour. Then I take shower. Then I come to town. As soon as I reach my office, I also start with a word of prayer. Then plus I read a verse in the Bible. Then I start. I have students whom I teach to do the decoration and the cake part of it. Then I teach, sometimes I have meetings. Also have to develop concepts. It depends, each day has different schedule.
So in this kind of business, who are the people that you look up to and you're like, when I look at him, I have hope that this business will once be a very big deal?
As for now, like, it's a hard question. But like, I was looking at, by the time when I joined the business, I was looking at Broven Events. They do some amazing work, and so, like I said, one day I'll become like them. Yeah.
Why would I choose to take on your company as opposed to the rest that are on the market?
First of all, I'm young, I'm energetic. I think I like advanced concepts. I have time to think beyond, whereby whenever I do a function, I sit down, I do a concept for a client, and whichever function which I do, it's different from which I did last time. Yeah.
So what kind of team do you work with to actually ensure that your decoration and your baking services are perfect?
I have a person who works on the lighting. I have those who do the table setup. I have those who do flower arrangements. I have those who do the walkway and the bridal setup. Each person does his own part.
So let's say there's a weekend that comes and you have more than one event. How do you handle that?
I don't exceed 2 events per weekend because of my team. And because I want to be on point and want to satisfy my customer, I don't exceed two functions per weekend.
So would you say your company is where you would have wanted it to be at this point in time?
Yeah.
You don't regret having left?
I can't regret because life has changed. I've helped many people. I'm employing a lot of people. I've trained a lot of people, whereby I'm happy where I am.
So what are the key issues or what are the key notes that someone should look out for if they want to be very good decorators, especially the youth out there that would want maybe to join this industry at one point?
First of all, they need to be creative and they need to be open-minded, whereby they don't just stuck on one thing. They need to open their mind, they need to go beyond what people think. Then they also need to connect with those people already in the industry, whereby they can groom them, they can mentor them, because you always have to have someone. What can help you?
What is it that helps you raise a team that is good at what you do? Are there some particular points or issues that you look at in someone before you employ them under a classic event?
First of all, those I employ, I taught them. They're my students and they know things more. Some of them come to learn. After that, then I retain them. And they know the business moves and they know how we do our things as a classic event.
So how do you manage to balance baking, decoration, events management, and all of that, you as an individual?
For the baking part of it, the baking is not here, it's in Mango. I have someone there who does the baking and helps me in the cake icing. Then for the decoration.
So would you say that what you're doing is not a very big issue, or is it something that actually takes a lot of time and thinking?
It takes a lot of time and thinking.
Because remember, as I told, like each wedding, I have to drop a different concept. That's why I'm always full in December period, because the clients can see. Whenever they see the pictures, they're not the same.
So if I have an event, do I come to you and agree on the packages, or if I have something out of what you have done before, you'll go ahead to learn it and be able to bring out the concept.
I'm a flexible person. I always want to learn new things. We just sit down, then we draw the concept, then I take it on.
So can you take us through a day when you have to decorate at an event? What does it take? How do you start it off? And how do you finally bring off the good pictures that we see?
For example, when I have a function on Saturday, we start preparing by Wednesday. We make a list of the things we are going to use. We arrange them. Then we visit the site. Then after that, on Fridays, early in the morning, we get a truck, we park our things on the car. We start to decorate on the venue. We decorate even during the night.
So about the baking, since you bake for very big events, is it that you use a complicated machinery or do you use your homemade ovens?
No, I use complicated machinery. Yes, because like there are a lot of orders and it's a commercial thing.
But you said you only work with one person in the bakery. How do
bakery is the chief chef, then there's the other people who he works with.
I'm Joan Namwonge. I'm a trainee at A-Class Events.
I'm Jemima Muronjo. I work with Ronnie Bob Photography.
This is a passion because according to my mom, she wanted me to go to campus. But I was like, mommy, I want this, and she took me this.
Like I've learned a lot and I've gained a lot from it. I've learned it and I can start my own as a result of studying here.
I've learned some good things. I can make a recipe for a cake, a table setup.
I can do photography, I can do editing, I can do videography, I can do decoration. Yes.
The challenge is going out at night to decorate stuff, but anything else, I have no problem with it.
I've gained a lot in my mind, practically, mindfully. I've gained a lot.
Well, so much info being given here by Amon Bazira, especially for you out there that one day would want to have a decoration company. Let's take a very short break, but we return with much more from the Legit Hustlers.